because you're not an idiot. Let's just humor him. Yates likes his little games.
Don't be long.
You got my message.
You'd never get caught on camera. Not unless you wanted to be seen. So what's the play?
You're not the only one who's been busy, 47. I'm this close to becoming the next Constant. I'll be able to dismantle Providence from the inside. Only one man stands in my way. Don Yates. That weasel was the partner's legal counsel for years. He's the top candidate. But remove him from the playing field.
It won't work. If Edward suspects...
I will convince him you acted alone. Retaliation for Gray. Trust me, I know what I'm doing.
The Herald, Tamara Vidal. She has eyes everywhere, and they're all fixed on you. The plan won't work unless we take her out.
She never leaves my side for long. Whatever your plan is, I'll help you if I can.
You're sure about this?
As sure as I'll ever be. Here, I got you an invitation, just like old times. Come find me when it's done. Good luck, 47.
Ready, Pam? 3, 2, 1, and...
For more than 2 decades, New York-based law firm...
Valentina must be over the moon about Tom stepping down. She's been living alone here for, what, 6 years? Ever since the scandal that ruined her career.
Bienvenidos to Viñeda Yates, señor. May I see your invitation, please? Gracias, señor. Enjoy the party. Aye!
It was the most charming little village.
Tell me you
almost
did.
Made it onto the UNESCO.
Tell me you didn't forget yourself.
Okay. I didn't forget your teleport.
Not that excited about a church wedding, to be honest. I think she only agreed to it to keep the family happy.
What's the alternative?
Part? Her parents will break for the next year.
Lots of people have mixed feelings about retirement. That's probably it.
Yates loves a good party. Plus, everyone knows he's not actually retiring.
Guys like him never do.
It was that letter earlier. He was all smiles up until then. Something about a late addition to the guest list.
Burnwood, Diana, you too.
Not a clue. But Yates doesn't usually get upset with people. He just gets hungry.
I'll run an ID check. Probably not.
Just a puddle either. We're talking to me. The whole place is like a horror movie. It's called the Gate.
Nothing quite spoils a party like your guests inexplicably dropping dead.
Corvo, got a message from the boss. Duty calls.
Let me guess, the Burnwood woman.
That's right. Yates has arranged for the chief winemaker to take Burnwood and Tamara Vidal on a grand tour of the estate. Wants you to tag along.
Not for my sparkling personality. This Burnwood woman sure has his panties in a twist. Wonder what the deal is.
Yates' business is his business. Just get yourself ready and sign into the visitor center. Oh, have a drink on my behalf.
I don't drink. It makes me sentimental.
For killing how many of our people? But how could she be a herald?
Maybe Vidal will trim her downstairs.
Those heels. Why he chose her to show Burnwood with the rope. But with the rest of us, he must have driven to
the Excuse me, sir. Seems like you're not cleared to come through here. Sorry.
Thank you.
This is a no-go. You can't pass through here.
Johannesburg Hall.
Larry. Mr. Yates. Sorry, how can I help you? The 1945 Grand Paladin. Why, yes, I will tell the Somelier right away. You're welcome, Mr. Yates. Oh, and congrats. Excuse me, Mr. Flowers?
What is it? What do you need? Get it yourself.
It's Mr. Yates. He wants the 1945 Grand Paladin brought up to the house right away.
Hey, what? Well, what for?
Special occasion is all he said.
Oh, my dear sweet Lawrence, no occasion is that special.
That good, huh?
You have no idea. Ugh. Fine. It's his blunder.
Shopping list on the Mona Lisa. Oh, men like Don Yates know the price of everything, but the value of nothing.
I am sorry, Butler. Say, what if we exchanged the labels? Served him a different wine.
Ah, you are devious, Santino. But no. If Mr. Yates wishes to destroy something beautiful, I will not stand in his way. That is between him and his creator.
How did he even get his hands on a bottle? I hear the last of the 45s were sold to Sheikh Omar al-Ghazali for $600,000. Most expensive bottle ever sold.
Ah, yes. A curious story. See, that bottle you refer to came from a case of 12, which were recovered from a sunken Carlisle shipping container that went down in the South China Sea during the final days of World War II. Of those 12, only 5 were raised intact. Al-Ghazali bought one under great media coverage, while the others simply disappeared, quietly obtained by some clandestine private collector. Until one of the bottles was donated to Mr. Yates by Byron Washington, CEO of the Pax Mundus Foundation, as a reward for winning a court case. Now, Byron's twin daughters were treasure hunters, so that explains how he managed to get first pick. Ah, but you see, I was here when... when the bottle arrived, and the crate it arrived in bore a curious logo. Something called the Ark Society.
Intriguing.
Do you know what it means?
Well,
not a clue. And now, we will never know. Don't get attached, Santino. For all fine things in life are transient.
If I don't hear flames crackling soon, I'm heading back to the hotel.
Church canceled, and now we're not sure if we want to rebook it.
I wouldn't.
She's not that excited about a church wedding, to be honest. I think she only agreed to it to keep the family happy.
What's the other? Park? Apparently, the next year. I don't know that.
Thank you.
Lots of people have mixed feelings about retirement. That's probably it.
Yates loves a good party. Plus, everyone knows he's not actually retiring.
Guys like him never do.
Yeah. It was that letter earlier. He was all smiles up until then. Something about a late addition to the guest list.
Fernwood, Diana, who's she?
Not a clue. But Yates doesn't usually get upset with people. He just gets hungry.
I'll run an ID check. Probably an extra.
Thank you.
I have always considered the Heralds the unspoken heroes of Providence. The nervous system, effectively and reliably transmitting the decrees of the brain to the body and limbs of our great organization. And I am delighted that so many of you were able to join me today, despite your busy schedules, and celebrate my retirement from the world of law and imminent instatement as the third constant of Providence. Make no mistake, I have two formidable sets of shoes to fill, but I am athirst to pick. Ah, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Flowers, our resident sommelier. I believe he has brought us something quite special. Perhaps you will educate us, Mr. Flowers.
This is the 1945 Grand Paladin, one of five bottles.
Stage fright, Mr. Flowers? Well, it's only the most expensive bottle of wine in existence. No introduction needed, I suppose. Moving on. This wine was gifted to me by the Art Society in acknowledgement of my firm's legal services. It stands as a powerful reminder that Providence draws its strength not from force, but from partnership. We are but a few, and yet together we are unstoppable because we stand united. My friends, loyalty is everything, which is why we cannot allow traitors into our ranks.
Ah, yes. Here it comes.
This woman has waged bloody war on us. More than a dozen heralds and operatives dead. Your colleagues and clients, my friend Ken Morgan. Not to mention the partners themselves, our founders, our benefactors. Make no mistake, this woman's hands are soaked in blood. Our blood! And Arthur Edwards, the new supreme head of Providence, is handing her the keys to the kingdom. Now, does that seem right to you, my friends? Does that sound like loyalty?
Absolutely.
Perhaps Edwards simply recognizes talent when he sees it. Perhaps this is why I am also in the running to become constant and following this childish outburst. I dare say I am in the lead, Dawn.
You're lying, of course, which only proves my point. You cannot be trusted, Miss Burnwood. This woman will be our downfall. That is, unless we take matters into our own hands. You are heralds, sworn to protect Providence against all threats, including inside ones. I have devised a plan. Together we can make it work, but you have to decide now, my friends. Are you with me?
Yes.
Yes.
I agree. Yes.
Listen to yourselves. Don Yate is not even appointed constant yet. And already he conspires to betray his master. I don't pretend to understand Edward's every move, but I do know that this man is an opportunist and unworthy of office.
Then you are a traitor to the Heralds. The room is against you, Tamara. Stand down now, or share her fate.
Edwards will hear about this.
I think not. I am sorry, but you brought this on yourself. Mr. Cortazar? Escort Miss Burnwood to my office. I'll join you shortly.
Right. Move in. Let's go.
I'm warning you, Yates. This will not go your way.
We need to get our story straight. Diana Burnwood died today by the hand of her rogue agent 47. Tamara Vidal, who saw through the assassin's disguise, was, alas, killed as well. This is what you will all attest to.
Yes.
Yes, yes. I agree.
Yes.
Before Yates' goons turn impatient.
Good. I was beginning to worry.
Were you?
No. Status?
Yates is down.
Well done. Finish what you need to do, and then meet me on the dance floor. Oh, and make sure to suit up.
Hello there.
Hello. One of the most gifted surveillance specialists ever to graduate from Kent. Ran one of our interrogation
plans. 47.
It's done. Now what?
Now, we strike at the heart.
Edwards. You know how to find him, don't you?
Why, Edwards finds you, 47. He is untraceable, and he never lets you forget it. He is cocky, and that will be his downfall.
What's the plan?
Too many eyes. Meet me at the Olive Grove at sunset. One last tango, 47.